Hello to all my day drinkers out there, I'm Martini Pictures, and welcome back to Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu! I know that the series has ended, but what I like to do at the end of each series is create a ghost episode or an extra episode, just doing all the other stuff that I can do in the game really quickly to showcase all the extra stuff that is available. I do know for a fact that once you become a champion, you can talk to the guy at the caretaker facility, and then there's a cerulean cave that you can access only if you become a champion. But then I can also try and catch transfer some of my Pokemon Go Pokemon to complete the Pokedex as well, and maybe I'll try and see if I can like transfer over like a Machop or Machoke and see if that works to try and get Machamp or something like that, like Graveler to Golem, like if that counts as a link trade. I doubt it, but there's no harm in trying, right? Alright. Hey, it's Ethan again.
Anybody home? Hey, Jade. I'm coming up. Morning, Kanto champion. But don't get too comfortable with that title. I plan on stealing it from you soon. First, though, did you hear the rumors? There's talk going around about some crazy strong-looking Pokemon being spotted.
What kind of Pokemon?
I hear it looks super strong and super cool. The Pokemon was seen near Cerulean City. And apparently, it ran away into the cave somewhere there. It ran into a cave somewhere over there. That's all I know. So, I said we both go and try to catch this Pokemon. Whoever catches it first is the winner.
Alright. Sure. Your world has expanded after becoming champion. You can now fly up in the sky with Charizard, Aerodactyl, and Dragonite anywhere you want. Wait, what? I'm still lost about the other thing, but...
Hey, sorry to bug you while your world's expanding. Remember me? I'm Ronnie from Route 1. Now that you successfully become a champion, I've got some moves for you. The Master Trainers, trainers that have spent their whole careers training one specific Pokemon, have appeared throughout Kanto. I'd say challenging the Pikachu Master is a good place to start. Head to Viridian Forest if you want to face her. If you want to know the details, talk to me.
Okay, kid, how about you explain a little bit to me of what's going on?
What do you want to know about the Master Trainers?
Who are they?
The Master Trainers have each focused on training one species of Pokemon. They're always thinking about the Pokemon they've spent all that time with, so you should be able to find them pretty easily.
Huh. Okay. How do I battle them?
If you have the same species of Pokemon as them, you'll be able to battle them, one-on-one. Neither side will be allowed to use items, so it'll be a battle of pure skill. If you win, you'll receive a title, and you'll be able to use it from that point on.
Okay. So, about these titles.
You can change the title you're using at the game company in Celadon City. Show it off during Link battles.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I'm okay. I don't really need to do that. Oh, that must be one of those trainers. He trained a Pidgey for his entire life? What kind of... What? I may as well try and see, like, what this trainer's all about. Ah, so that's the Pikachu Master. So does she trigger, like, the other trainers? Nope. She's like a coach trainer. You only interact with her.
I'm the Pikachu Master. My goal is to find the ultimate Pikachu. Hey, your Pikachu looks pretty strong. Can I battle it with my Pikachu? Please?
Sure,
Let's see which is stronger. Which is the stronger Pikachu?
Alright. Let's just see what this last Ikui? Ikui? Ikui. Something. I did not realize that it was gonna be a giant jump from level 54. I think that was the last Pokemon I ever fought, level 54, to level 75. Okay, I'll try. I doubt that I'll win because it's just. God damn it. Oh, yay! Way to go, Pikachu! And she's gonna use another Toxic because I already got rid of it. So this is gonna get rid of 2/3 of her health. Yep. Okay. So this is... I didn't really have to worry about this. This is kind of unfair right now. Stronger against physical moves. Don't really have to worry. I'll just use Zippy Zap as a speed priority and get the 1% damage left. There we go.
That strength is the real deal.
Thank you.
Oh, wow. Your Pikachu is way stronger than I thought. I think you deserve to be called a Pikachu Master. You have earned the title of...
Oh, you have earned the title of Pikachu Master.
We should have another battle sometime, since we both love Pikachu so much.
Yeah, first things first, this guy said to visit him after I became the champion.
Ho ho, what's this now? You've become the champion. I'm Mr. Hyper. I train level 100 Pokemon with my special move, Hyper Training. I fucked that up. I train level 100 Pokemon with my special Hyper Training. Bring me a bottle cap and I'll train one stat. Bring me a gold bottle cap and I'll train all of a Pokemon's stats at once. If you want me to train up your Pokemon, bring me some bottle caps.
That's only level 100, though. So is this guy now a coach trainer, or is he, like, just here to ask me if I can go in? Well, I can go in.
Hey, champion. You're allowed to enter this cave. From now on, I'll face you as a coach trainer. Are you ready? Then let's battle. Are you ready, champion?
Probably not, because the last person I faced had a level 75 Pokemon. Harjeet? Oh god, he's got 5. And he's got a Rhydon. To start off the battle. Oh, level 52. Okay, that's not as bad as I thought. Splishy Splash. Although, this will probably lead to my death. Oh, never mind then. Hey, Blastoise grew to level 53. Nidoking. That's ground and poison, so I'll just stick with this. I'm noticing that both of these Pokemon have, like, a horn. So I'm thinking it's gonna be some sort of horn move. Damn it. Earthquake. Great, it lands a critical hit now. send in Rapidash. It's gonna have Flare Blitz. Keep battling, I guess. It's gonna have Flare Blitz because that's all anybody knows is,
ooh, power! I can use it, even though that I don't know I'm gonna die from it. Yeah.
Oh, that works. Hey, Pikachu grew to level 69. Dewgong. That's ice and water, so I'll just keep battling. Probably Thunderbolt. I think it's physical defense, because it's like a blubbery sort of Pokemon. Speaking of blubber, one of my all-time favorite episodes of Fairly Odd Parents, and I know that show is no longer going, the basketball one with Blubber Nuggets. I don't know why, just always was. And Sea King, I'll use probably Zippy Zap now. Yeah, every Pokemon of his had a horn. So he's probably gonna give me something like Horn Drill or something. Oh no, he's gonna give me that horn move that's a one-hit KO, but he can't use it because my level was higher. That's exactly what it's gonna be. Watch it. Hey, Rhydon grew to level 47.
Is this the power of the top trainer?
Not really. It's the power of one Pokemon, but close enough, right? So what you gonna give me?
What a great battle. That's what I expected from a champion. I didn't stand a chance. Please accept this from me.
Mega Horn. Oh, that's the bug. That's the bug type 120 power. Horn move.
I hear the Pokemon in the Cerulean Cave are terrifyingly strong. Of course, I'm just a guard, so I don't know for sure.
Terrifyingly strong, yet you don't really battle them. Oh. Huh. So, this is the first time going into a Pokemon Center after getting, like, any damage on Pikachu. Apparently, the, label is now connected to my name from now on. Welcome to the Pokemon Center, Pikachu Master Jade. Okay. Well, I can safely say I can enter Cerulean Cave and see what all this hype is about, but I don't know if I'll make it out alive. Oh, hey, a Lickitung. I didn't even mean to do that. I was just exploring. I guess. This is a level 55, and with a Great Ball, I don't know if this will work or not. And why did it do that? It's close enough. It's fairly consistent in getting two shakes with a Great Ball every time. There we go. It's kind of like a more white than pink. There we go. Charizard. 989 experience. Jeez, I didn't even notice. Charizard is now 47. Its tongue spans almost 7 feet and moves more freely than its forelegs. Its licks can cause paralysis. Yes. Hence the move Lick, available to Lickitung and Ghost types. It's a Ghost type move, right? Yeah. Which I think is weird. So after exploring in this cave a little bit and finding a Lickitung, I can safely say that there's like 8 No, there's 7 ladders going up and 1 ladder going down, I think, if I counted them correctly. I wasn't really trying to count them. I just happened to see a few. And I think there were 3 on one side and 4 on the other. But I know that this is the first ladder that you can go up, and I don't know what they really do. So there was only items and Pokemon up there. Ah, it's that ladder over there. Gotcha. And then there's only 1 ladder that connects from the second floor to the first floor to go down to the basement floor. Or what I would consider the basement floor, because this is the main floor. So I'm gonna hope that this is probably the right way. Pikachu's gotta say something. Pikachu feels the tension in the air and seems a little afraid. Yeah, so I'm at least going the right way, I suppose. After being on a few of these islands in other battles, I know for certain that this is supposed to be a special battle against Pokemon that I can catch, like Articuno, Zapdos, and Moltres. And I can only assume of what this is supposed to be. I've caught one once before, I think, and that was in X and Y, when they first introduced Mega Evolutions, and I got X, and then I got Y a little bit later, so I think I know what this is supposed to be. I'm gonna save here just in case. Just in case I happen to mess up horribly. Yeah. Sorry, big guy. There's a reason why you ran away, isn't there? Sorry, bud. Mewtwo appeared, and Mewtwo's stats rose. Alright, let's see. Let's see what we got. Level 70. Ah, my Pikachu's only level 69, so only one away. Thunderbolt should be fine. This is Mewtwo's only psychic, right? What? Oh my god! Zippy Zap just to get some, like, damage at least somewhat going. Oh. Wait, that seemed like it did more. Okay, so physical damage is probably better. Yeah, we'll use an X Pokemon. Physical damage is probably better than, special damage. Dragonite's a little bit further off compared to Pikachu. Outrage is all I can really do to hope for. Oh, thank you. Mewtwo's probably got, like, Recover or something. I wonder if I have anything that use next Pokemon. Blastoise is the next best thing, which I'm afraid of. I just need something to do at least some damage. Mega Evolution and Bite, please. I know Blastoise isn't gonna be faster than it, but I just hope. Ah, shit. Yeah. Okay. time to restart and reset my thoughts for a better strategy. Okay, so I know that its special defense is going to be incredibly high, so I want to use physical attacks instead. However, I know for a fact that I can get at least 2 hits off with Pikachu using a speed priority move. I can at least get 1 hit off with Dragonite, and nothing really else. Nothing else could withstand a move. Because Blastoise only got that bite because it used Recover instead. So I'll use Dragonite. And then physical, we'll use Outrage. What does that raise? Special defense? Okay, yeah. Alright, just another reason as to why I should... What? I know that was a critical hit, but... Okay. Come on, don't confuse now, please. Oh, you bitch. Alright, we'll switch out Pokemon and... I know it's not nice, but I'll switch out Venusaur, or switch out Dragonite for Venusaur, just to remove the confusion. Actually, if possible, I could probably poison. Use the poison powder. I mean. It's worth a shot, right? Oh wait, Psychic's super strong against poison, isn't it? Yeah. Oh well. This is kind of what I wanted instead, to bring Dragonite back out. Okay, Mewtwo's used 3 recovers, I think? That was another critical hit. He's using Psychic again. That's fine. Use next Pokemon. I'll try Pikachu this time. And I just have to focus with Zippy Zap. And now it's gonna recover. Oh my god! Oh, please withstand. Oh, thank god. Okay. Alright, now I've got this in the bag. Fight. And Zippy Zap. There we go. It's okay, big guy. Now I can just catch Mewtwo. Bag, and because it's literally the strongest Pokemon available, I'm just gonna use the Master Ball. Don't really care. Does it automatically suck it in, or can I actually miss with this? Oh. Oh, okay. It had me worried. I thought it blocked it. I was about to say. There we go. And as I look over, I'm literally just under an hour. Perfect. And Mewtwo's data, just like Mew was at the very start of the journey, is gold. Its DNA is almost the same as Mew's. However, its size and disposition are vastly different. Both Mew and Mewtwo have had a hard life. It's hard to think that. Holy Jesus, fuck! Look at that special attack! 236! Oh, hey, Ethan.
Hey, Jade! Oh, wait, don't tell me. You already caught that super strong Pokemon, didn't you? I knew it. So it's called Mewtwo, huh? Man, you got to Mewtwo before me or that girl. Huh? Oh, I ran into this gusty girl who said she was looking for a powerful Pokemon. I think she meant Mewtwo. Well, I guess that's that. Here, take these. I won't need them now.
You got 3 escape ropes.
I just saw that girl come in here too. She must be still looking for Mewtwo. You should go show it to her.
I don't know if that'll be really well received. Even though it is kind of cheap, I think I should add Mewtwo onto my team in place of Venusaur, maybe. You know, just in case I am ambushed by this girl and I can't do anything about it. So after going in, catching what I wanted, coming back out, I have to go back in and talk to this girl that I kind of stole her super rare Pokemon. Whoops. Who the fuck are you? Oh. Ow. You were hit by a low-flying Pokeball. Oh, wait. Did it hit me in the gut, or...
Oh, whoops. You're not a Pokemon. Sorry, it's so dark in here. I saw you and I thought you were some kind of Pokemon. Well, nice to meet you. I'm Green.
So are you like the counterpart to Red of the original games?
So, hey, I'm just curious. Are you here because you're looking for, you know, something special? Right, Mewtwo. Drat, so you knew about it already, huh? What? You already caught it? Hey, no fair. I was planning on catching it first.
Yeah, I didn't think it was gonna go too well. Ah, at least she's got 6 going on. Clefable. Okay. Keep my dragon type away from that. Level 66. Yikes. I'll test out Zippy Zap first and then go over to Thunderbolt to see which is stronger. Okay, did that. Strong against physical moves, gotcha. Thunderbolts. Very high special defense. Special attack fell. God damn it. It's like everything's just falling into her hands easily. Damn it. Better not have a fucking potion or something like that. Zippy zap. I don't even know, like, the typing for fairies. Like, I'll have to look at that, because I still don't know them. And it's been... how many games? X, Y, Sun, Moon, Ultra Sun, Moon, and now Let's Go. Ninetales. Switch Pokemon. I guess Blastoise, sure. I'll have Blastoise start out, and then I'll use Pikachu's Surf move. Just in case, I want to save my Mega Evolution for Charizard, just in case, because I know Blastoise is stronger, but there might be a chance that I'll need... What? Hyper Beam! That's my boy! Hey, the Reflect wore off. Bubble Beam, I guess, again. Yeah. Yeah, and Ninetales needs to recharge because of that. I wish for, like, the recharging stage, like, it would lower, like, some of the stats of the other Pokemon. Another Hyper Beam. Sorry, Blastoise. It's okay, bud. Pikachu, I'll use Splishy Splash, especially now when it's recharging. Perfect. Victory Bell. Switch. May as well use Charizard now, see if I can do anything with that. Yeah, we'll see. Mega evolve it now. Ah, okay, so that's how you do it. Hold on, give me a second. Let me... Pokemon... what's higher? It's attack. Gotcha. Now let me... I know this is cheating, but I don't really care. What raises its attack? Which form of Charizard raises its attack a little bit higher? X or Y? I'm thinking Y is special attack. Yep, so I'll have to go with X for the Mega Evolution for this. Mega Evolution X and Wing Attack. Yeah, sure. And now it's Fire and Dragon. Any grass type move that it uses now. Oh my god, it's. It is way faster than Victory Bell. Holy shit. And that was a critical hit. Okay. Do I want to use Dragon Rage or do I want to use Wing Attack again? Probably Wing Attack. Another Poison Jab. Charizard, will you hold on for me? Dang it. No. Okay. It was worth a shot. Mewtwo has a Psychic over Poison. I probably should have done that instead. I'm an idiot. Show this right off in front of her. Psychic Mewtwo. What the? They planned that out. They definitely planned that out. Send out Gengar. Switch. Dragonite. Alright, can you do an outrage for me, Dragonite? Will-O-Wisp. Great. Alright, at least it's just a minor burn. It's not like Toxic where it gets worse every single fucking time. Yeah! Nice, Dragonite! And she's gonna use another Will-O-Wisp to do it. Yeah! Dragonite's such a good boy. Ah, shit. He's confused after two. Yes! Yes! Dragon Tail? Maybe I can get past the confusion. Probably not. Okay, burned and confusion? Shit, I thought so. Alright, yeah, it was gonna happen regardless. Dragon Tail. What move is Gengar gonna use now? Sludge Bomb? Snapped out of its confusion, yeah! What? I would have thought that would have killed it. Alright, Kangaskhan is now out here. Outrage. Fucking Dizzy Punch, damn it. Rhydon, I guess. Rhydon against Kangaskhan. We're both down to three. This is not good for me. Mega Horn, I guess. That's all I can really do. Done. Oh, he withstood that somehow. Oh, God, Lord Geezer. Oh, way to go, Rhydon. Another one. Critical hit? No. It's okay. Way to go, Rhydon, somehow. Critical hit. That's my boy or girl. Can you do this again? How is this happening? Where to go? Dizzy Punch? Ah, damn. Thank you so much, Rhydon. Mewtwo, because special attack is overpowered. Sucker Punch, god damn it. Ugh. Send out Gengar. Switch to Pikachu. Maybe get a cheeky little zip zap off. Yeah. Zip zap. Good. Alright. She's down to one, I'm down to two, barely. She's about to send in Blastoise. Okay, yeah, I'll keep battling with Pikachu. She probably has Mega Evolution for this, doesn't she? So do I want Zippy Zap or Thunderbolt? Hold on, let me look at my own Blastoise's stats, and I'll base it off of that. Blastoise... let's see. Regular defense? Special defense, for sure. And even my special defense was being boosted, so it's definitely special defense. Thunderbolt! Uh-oh. Hydro Pump? What are the odds? That's my girl.
Come on, what's with that?
19,000. Yikes.
Wow, you're strong. Well, I guess that's that. Here, you can have these.
Oh, Mewtwo Knight X and Mewtwo Knight Y. Thank you.
Oh, I know. Why don't you become one of my Pokemon, together with Mewtwo?
Okay. I won't become a Pokemon, but can we settle on a relationship? That's fine with me. I will not become a slave. A Pokeball came flying at you. She's just gonna keep throwing them at me. Another one came flying at me. She's not gonna stop. Four?
Think about it, okay?
Is that a proposal? Cause I'd be down. Cause like, if they introduce that into the game, I'd be hella down. And I get 5 free Pokeballs. Can you ever find her again in this game? Well now, I guess I just go down to Fuchsia City, go to the Go Park complex, raise up the last few Pokemon that I can, and this adventure should end. Unless I can meet with Green again, because I'd be down. Wait a minute. Is that like a hidden lore thing? Wait a minute, no, she can't be the counterpart of Red and Blue, because she's the same age as Ethan and I. Is that going to be introduced if they make a Let's Go Johto? Like I said, like in other episodes, what's my character's name? Like, I know that every character in every Pokemon game has had a set name. Like in the Hoenn regions, where Sapphire, Ruby, and Emerald, there was Mei, who was introduced in the actual anime, and then Brendan, I think, was the male. Was supposed to be the male's name if you chose to play as Mei, but inserted your own name or whatever as her. I think it's Brendan. So what would be my character's name? And how have I not thought about that? For the Pokedex that I don't have Ekans, but I was able to send it over with the help of someone through the comments. Thank you, Kara. Kara Cruz, I think. I have Vulpix in my account. I have Meowth in my account. Kadabra, I might have on my account. I don't think so. Machoke, I don't think I have. Bellsprout, I was able to send over because I have a Weepin' Bell in my account. But through the help of Kara, I was able to send that over. I don't think I have a Haunter to send over to think about Gengar. Koffing, I know I have. Pinsir, I know I have. Ammonite, I know I have. And that should be it, really. Yeah. Okay, so I need to send over... Regroup, I need to send over Vulpix, Meowth, Koffing, Pinsir, and Ammonite. Start up the search for the account. I still have to load it up on here. Okay, let me show you how you have to do it. So if I can get this to focus, as you can see, I've got my account here, and in the top left, yeah. Because I'm looking in a mirror image for my webcam, so it's kind of backwards, but it's not at the same time. So in the top left corner over here, there's a Nintendo Switch button that you have to press to access the main menu. Still not right in coloration. There we go. You have to turn that mode on, otherwise you're just transferring the Pokemon to the professor to get candies for it, which is a bad idea if you forget. So I need to send over Firefox, send over Scritch, Obnoxious Gas, Beetle, and I'ma put a cap in, and send it a Nintendo Switch, 5. Right down at the bottom, you just send them all to the Nintendo Switch. Boop. Come on. Yes, I would like to transfer all of them. Beep. Okay. My account has been found, and I would like to receive the Pokemon. Yes. Okay. And over here, you can clearly see that the Pokemon have been sent to my Switch. Yeah. Refocus. And as a bonus, you get this mystery box, which was the whole reason that Kara from one of my earlier videos even contacted me in the first place. He wanted a little bit of help trying to get this mystery box, which has a mysterious effect. I'll click OK. Get out of here. Go into my items. Access the mystery box. And I'll open it. And once you open it, what happens? Okay, so it kind of acts like a lure. Gotcha. I'll just keep this open on my side. Oh my god! Right off the bat, a Melton appeared. This is supposed to be the Pokemon that is only hidden in Pokemon Go that can be transferred over to Let's Go. And there we go! I've caught my first Melton! Melton is a steel type, and oh my god! Jesus, holy shit! Okay. So, to evolve this thing is exactly like Gyarados. It requires 400 candies, but I don't know if it'll ever focus. It requires 100 candies and 100,000 Stardust to get a new attack. I don't play this enough, but I think that's actually really hard to get. Another Melton. I'm just gonna continue to catch Melton for a little bit. Excuse me. I know this is gonna sound a little bit dumb, but I'm actually just gonna walk around my house for a little bit until this wears out. Because it is a timed mystery box thing to catch Melton, and I don't know if it just attracts Melton, or it might attract some of the evolved form of Melton, which I really want, because I don't want to spend 400 candy. Ooh, another one. So I'll be back later. So the 30 minutes for the Melton box are just about up. There's 30 seconds left, and I caught quite a few. Once this timer goes off, I can actually say how much I ended up getting, because I might get one last one in the last 18 seconds that I have left. Who knows? I might get one last one, and then it'll be the mother of all Meltons, which is the evolved form, maybe. Last second? A reward for catching all of them in that allotted time? Nope. Guess not. Oh well. So, in the end, after everything that I went through, I caught 19 Meltons. yeah. Well, that's pretty nice. After catching 19 Meltons, you get 57 candy and 18 more for transferring them. And it can be transferred to here if you want, but you don't really see the use for that. I can understand, like, sending over the, the one to catch, but not all 18. And then I just need one to evolve. But the way that you're supposed to be able to do this is you're supposed to get the box every time you send over a Pokemon that you can send over to Let's Go. And then you just open up the box and you get all these. So it actually kind of seems possible to get the 400 candy to evolve it. Because you at least get 50 in one go. So that means you only have to do it at least 8 times. And it goes pretty quickly. But you just have to make sure that you have enough battery and you have enough Pokeballs or Ultra Balls or Great Balls. Because I was literally down to like my last 15 Ultra Balls because there's nothing in my area, like remote area, to give me anything. Like there's no Pokestops for the next 20 minute walk, I think. So, it's not the best for me, but I'm just surprised that I got that many Melton in the area that I live, because I thought, like, it would just attract, like, 3 at most, but this was pretty good. So, I'll send over one of them, and transfer the rest, and I'll keep one to evolve, just in case I want to, transfer over one of them to over here, and transfer the rest to the professor. I'll be able to do that. Try that again, and okay, it's sent. Good. Bonus XP. Days remaining to mystery box access. 7? Send Pokemon to Nintendo Switch to activate your mystery box when the above counts down to 0. Okay, so once a week, you can send over any Cantonian available Pokemon and get one of those boxes. Let's see. Once a week. So, after about 2 months, you'd get a Meltan. Okay. That's where it starts to draw the line a little bit, I guess. Sorry. All those hopes and dreams are a little bit crushed now. Okay, so I've saved, and I just want to see if I can catch the Pokemon or just bring them into my collection or whatever. What would I like to do? I'd like to enter a Go Park, please. Enter Go Park number 8, or 1, with the 8 Pokemon. Pokemon have to be somewhere, right? Oh, look at all of them! They're all grouped together! Hey! Stop that! Don't run away! Okay, so you have to interact with them. Gotcha. Yeah, I'll catch. If you catch a Pokemon in a Go Park, the Pokemon's information will be changed from when it was in Pokemon Go. Is that okay? Yeah, I don't see any issue in that. Does that mean that if I don't catch this now, it'll run away? God damn it. And this is like Pokemon Go. Like, I only have a limited number of Pokeballs. So I don't have any more Pokeballs left, so I'm just gonna catch him with Great Balls now. Oh, please don't. There we go. Nice. Nobody got anything from that, barely. Coughing's data. In hot places, its internal gases could expand and explode without any warning. Be very careful. Noted. Hi, guys. Oh, hey, look, the Ekans came over. Yeah, this was, Kara Cruz is on YouTube, but Ignacio on, Pokemon Go, so who knows. And I transferred only the weakest ones so it wouldn't affect his account, because he or she had multiple ones of each Pokemon, so I wanted to clear it with him because he only wanted me to transfer anything over that I really like wanted, and I just said anything like this, and he said fine. But I was really thinking it was just anything along the lines of like Pidgey, something quick for him to catch, and these are kind of easy, Bellsprout and Ekans, so yeah, this was fine with him. Or her. Them. Whatever. What I don't really like is that it takes a few Pokeballs to catch this thing. Because not only does it take one to a lot of Pokeballs in Go, but it also takes a lot of Pokeballs in Let's Go as well. There we go. Very deep purple. Well, light purple, really. Deep light purple, if that makes sense. Kind of like Mewtwo's tail. Or Ekans' skin. I'm an idiot. The older it gets, the longer it grows. At night, it wraps its long body around tree branches to rest. Perfect. It's like a yellow green. I was about to say green yellow, but that's not how colors work. It's always primary and then secondary. Prefers hot and humid places. It ensnares tiny bugs with its vines and then devours them. I'm just like looking like in the location where I originally got him. Oh my god. So, fun fact, along with Pinsir and the opposite, Scyther. Why was that so easy to catch? Kind of like a brownish white. The opposite side of Pinsir is Scyther, obviously. And when I caught Scyther, the only time that I've ever seen it, and it was super strong. Like, if you look at it, like, the stats are all the way at the very end for Scyther. It was in New York City, and I got a curveball, and it was perfect. Right dead in the center when it was super tiny. Like, I thought I had messed up. But I didn't really know, like, the perfect throws existed at that time. It was the first time I had ever gotten a curveball and a perfect throw. And it just fell right into it. And it was the first throw, too. I caught it, and I was just like, eh, I'll go along with it. I think I caught it with a Pokeball, because I didn't think anything of it. And then I come onto the Let's Go, and I'm like, why can't I catch this fucking Scyther? Oh, wait, because I got extremely lucky on Go. Pinsir. Grips its prey in its pincers and squeezes hard. It can't move if it's cold out, so it lives in warm places. Mm-hmm. Let's go, buddy. Ah, you're a persistent little bugger, aren't you? Ah. Don't be like that, Vulpix. Come on. Also, I am not nicknaming my Ninetales Kurama or whatever it is from Naruto. I liked my name better. Bitch. Is there a chance for Vulpix to actually run away? And like not be caught? And like I missed my chance of actually having it. There we go. Ooh. That kind of scared me. That was a white orange color. Kind of like Charizard's stomach. I don't know where would it appear on. It's nowhere on Vulpix's body, the color that I saw. Both its fur and its tails are beautiful. Yes, yes they are. As it grows, the tails split and form more tails. Hence the reason, nine tails! However, it's spelled differently than what you would think. It's okay, bud. Aww. You just want to play hard to get, don't you? Stop it. Come on. There we go. Light blue. Exactly like the face. Yep, the exact same color. I didn't know if it was a little bit deeper. An ancient Pokemon that was recovered from a fossil. It swam by cleverly twisting its 10 tentacles around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. Okay. Caught it right on its toes. Stop it. Stop it, Scritch. Come on. There we go. White fur. Mm-hmm. The exact same color. What do you have to say about Meowth? Appears to be more active at night. It loves round and shiny things. It can't stop itself from picking them up. And I definitely don't want to lose this one, so what I'm going to do is just immediately switch to an Ultra Ball. What the fuck? Wait, that was a great throw? I don't even want to know what an excellent throw, how tiny that is. And somehow I got it. Come on, Melton, don't be like that. Just imagine if it has the power to break the balls. Why is it being so resistant? Okay, after this, I'm gonna use a... Oh my god. Fine. Golden Raspberry then, Jesus. Jesus. This will not catch. Jesus. Oh my god. Come on. Stop it. Oh my god. Uh-oh. Melton ran away. What does that mean? Oh. Okay.
Whew!
That made my heart drop. But then again, I had a whole bunch more in my Go account, so... So I can just continue to do this. You know, if the motion controls worked properly. There we go. Kind of like a weak gold color. Like it was almost like gold had rusted a little bit, or gold plus white. It did its best, like trying to go through the white center. You know, if I could control this right there. Like there's a white ring on the outside that shows like what the color is. I think just because the gold color got diluted by that is why I'm making it like that. Oh well. Alright, let's see Melton's description then. Melton may be a mythical Pokemon, but why doesn't it get gold lettering? It melts particles of iron and other metals found in the subsoil, so it can absorb them into its body of molten steel. Hexnut. Okay. Oh, that's what its tail is. I couldn't figure out what its tail was, like, in the Pokemon Go. It's a wire. It's an electrical wire. That's cute. Okay, so let me think about this. So, all I need is a Firestone for Vulpix. I can use my Rare Candy on Bellsprout to evolve it into Weepinbell right away. And then I can use a Leafstone on that. Koffing, Ekans, and an Omanyte are just levels. Gotcha. One second, let me go through all that. Vulpix is evolving. There we go. Ninetales. According to an enduring legend, nine noble saints were united and reincarnated as this Pokemon. Nine people into one. Okay. Is that actually how the legend of, like, the nine-tailed fox is supposed to go? And Rare Candy on Bellsprout. Bellsprout is now level 21. And Bellsprout evolves into Weepinbell at level 21. There we go. Perfect. When hungry, it swallows anything that moves. Its hapless prey is dissolved by strong acids. Yikes. There we go. Now my Weeping Bell is a Victory Bell. Lures prey with the sweet aroma of honey. Swallowed whole, the prey is dissolved in a day, bones and all. Much like a pig, it will literally eat everything that is put in front of it. Okay, so unfortunately it's going to be a while for me to Get some shit done. Get Ekans going, Coffin going. Ammonite is gonna take a while. And by a while, I mean it's gonna take level 40. Coffin is level 30 something. Ekans is at least close with 20 something. I don't really care, I'm just catching Pokemon. Let's see, catching a Golbat does what? 417? What does that raise? Okay. Ekans grew to level 13. Ammonite grew to 5, 6, 7, and 8. I don't know why that last one took so long. 746. Not bad. That got everybody pretty riled up. Pikachu even leveled up to level 70. Rhydon grew to level 48. Learn Rock Slide. Ooh, that'll probably be helpful. Rock Slide is what? 75 and 90. This may also make the opposing Pokemon flinch. Rock type. Rock Throw is 50 and 90. That's an upgraded Rock Throw. Yeah, because Mega Horn. Takedown. Drill Run. Yeah, it's an upgraded Rock Throw. Also, can we just talk about how Rhydon is literally the best Pokemon for withstanding, like, what was, like, I think 3 hits in that battle against Green? She's such a good Rhydon. Ekans grew to level 14 and 15. Coffin grew to level 15 and 16. Ammonite grew to level 9, 10, 11, it learned Leer, and 12. 345, okay, it's not as good, but it'll still do. Coffin grew to level 17, and Ammonite grew to level 13. So I think Machokes are where it's at. That, or maybe a Rhydon. I'll have to see what Rhydon's like. Okay, so a sized Golbat gave me 812. Gotcha. It's leveling up pretty quick. Dragonite grew to level 57. Ekans grew to level 16. Must have learned the move Haze. Let me check. What was Haze? Haze is ice, but it doesn't really do anything, right? Yeah, nah. I'll leave it. Nah, we'll keep old moves. Ekans grew to level 17. Coffin grew to level 18. Wants to learn the move Sludge. I actually just realized I'm using Ekans and Coffin. I've got Team Rocket right alongside of me. What should be forgotten and replaced with Sludge? Well, check it out. Let's see, what do we have? Poison Gas, Tackle, Smog, Clear Smog. Sludge. Okay, Sludge is 65. Unsanitary Sludge is also made Poison. 65 and 100. Clear Smog is 50. And Accuracy... Huh. So, Clear Smog always works? All stat changes are returned to normal. 50. Gotcha. Poison, 30 and 70. Yikes, that's actually quite a big chance. If we've learned anything from Thunder of missing, this may also poison the target. I think Sludge is a bigger version, a better version of Smog. Tackle is at least something versatile. Poison Gas is what? A cloud of poison gas is sprayed in the face of opposing Pokemon, poisoning those it hits. Oh, it's always... Okay, poison gas is always just a poisoning move. For now, I'll get rid of poison gas. Actually... No, like I... Okay, so in my head, this makes sense. Clear Smog would be a better version of Smog. So, getting rid of Smog with Clear Smog would leave room for me to put sludge in, so by doing that, I'll get rid of smog by adding sludge, but it would actually be clear smog getting rid of smog to add sludge in. Yeah. The poison gas just makes sense for coughing. It's like, Poliwhirl and, the spiral for hypnosis. Ammonite grew to level 14, and Ammonite grew to level 15. Hey, Ammonite learned water gun. So a Graveler, a normal Graveler, I think with a great throw, gave me 686. Okay. Not as good as Machoke, I think. Ekans grew to level 18. Coughing grew to level 19, and Ammonite grew to level 16. Okay, so this is a great throw for a Machoke, gave 530. What do I feel as if, like, the other one... I know that the other one was better, but why? I don't remember what was different about it. Ekans grew to level 19, Coughing grew to level 20, and Ammonite grew to level 17. Excellent sized first throw Machop gives me 676. Okay, and that is not anywhere near as high as I thought it would be. Ekans grew to level 20. Wants to learn to move Glare. I know that paralyzes, but does that do anything else? The pattern on its belly to cause paralysis. That doesn't really... Glare makes more sense for the actual eyes, not, like, the stomach. And that makes sense for, Arbok, but not Ekans. We'll switch out Leer, I guess, for Glare, because I think Ekans evolves now. And now that it has Glare, it makes sense for it, but oh well. Ta-da! And Ammonite grew to level 18. There we go. Okay, so this is an excellent sized Rhydon. Oh! I know what I should catch now. Ekans 21, Coughing 21, and Coughing 22. Ammonite level 19 and 20. Excellent combo, Rhydon. 974, okay. It's not as good as last time, but if I can get a sized combo and a first throw, that'll give me so much. Ekans gave, grew up to level 22. Coughing grew to level 23. And Ammonite is now level 21. It's already above the halfway point. Hey, look at that. Ekans is evolving. Into Arbok. The frightening patterns on its belly have been studied. 6 variations have been confirmed. What? There's only one. I've never seen a different pattern for Arbok. Ever. That makes no sense. Oh well. Oh, Arbok wants to learn the move Crunch. Hell yeah. Yeah, we'll forget an old move for that. Glare makes sense to keep. So let's see. Crunch is 80 and lowers defense. Bite is 60 and flinch. Acid is 40, lowers defense. I really don't know with this one. Because Glare makes sense to keep, but with my playstyle, I don't really like to have status moves. But Poison Sting will poison sometimes. acid is a stronger poison type for Arbok, which is a poison type. I guess I can upgrade Bite to Crunch. Ah, hell, why not? Just needed to try and evolve Koffing and then Ammonite. Focusing on Rhydons. Rhydon. Ah, another Rhydon. Sweet. Excellent combo. 1042. There we go. Koffing grew to level 24. Koffing wants to learn self-destruct. We'll see. Poison gas, tackle, sludge, clear smog, self-destruct. Koffing is like a bomb, in a sense. He's shaped like one of those sea mines. It knows self-destruct, and it's also like a dispersal pod for like smoke. So poison gas makes sense for it. But in the end, I think, yeah, poison gas can still miss. Yeah, I'll forget poison gas, because I think sludge can poison? Yeah, sludge can poison, so I'll get rid of poison gas for now. But it'll probably be overshadowed by explosion here to come a few levels from now. Ammonite grew to level 22. And Ammonite wants to learn the move Bite. Hell yeah. Wait, how does Ammonite bite anything? Constrict, withdraw, leer. I'll remove Leer for now, just because withdraw makes sense, but I'm removing withdraw as soon as I can. High leveled, Rhydon. Really, that's it. Just combo. 532. Not that special. Ammonite grew to level 23. Oh, please. Okay, bag. I want to try and get a first throw on this. Use Ultra Balls, but I'm gonna use a Golden Raspberry. And I'm trying to get an excellent throw. Why? Why? Are you fucking kidding me? I set all that up to get a perfect first throw, and it does shit like that. It gave me 1,595. Just imagine how much I would have gotten if I had gotten a first throw. Hey, my Rhydon is at level 49 now. My Venusaur is level 47. My Koffing is now level 25. Ammonite is now level 24. Excuse me, 25. Oh my god, a shiny Zubat! Oh my god! I didn't expect that to happen. I don't mind breaking my thing for now. Oh, please. Hell yeah. And it's green. I didn't realize it. They changed color on here as well. That is cool. Okay. Huh. Koffing grew to 100, level 26. I guess I can catch a sized Hitmonlee now. How much does a sized Hitmonlee give me? 996. Oh, with a great throw as well, so. It's pretty nice. Ammonite grew to level 26. Wants to learn the move Rock Throw. Yeah, sure, we'll forget an old move. Withdraw. 709 for a great Rhydon. Basically, that's it. Koffing is now level 27. Now, if I can get a sized one of those. Yeah, look at that. First throw, 1595. It's the exact same thing. Yeah. Perfect. Dragonite is now level 58. Dragonite's almost 60. Koffing is now level 28. Ammonite was level 27. And Ammonite is now level 28. Ammonite's gonna pass Koffing and leveling. It's gonna be 1595 again, isn't it? Yep. Man, that is so good. Pikachu is now level 71. Venusaur grew to level 48. Koffing grew to level 29. And Ammonite grew to level 29. And Ammonite is officially, like, past Koffing. Otherwise, it's dead even. I think it's a little bit past. Without a first throw, it's a 1,063. There we go. My Rhydon is now officially transcended into level 50. Koffing is level 30. Koffing wants to learn the move Toxic. Okay. Now we're starting to get somewhere. Clear Smog, Sludge, Tackle, Self-Destruct. You know what? I have the TM Toxic, so it doesn't really matter if I keep Toxic or not. Nah. Keep old moves. Come on. And Ammonite is now level 30. Sized Rhydon! Oh, please. Please. Bag. Golden Raz. Don't cuck me on this. Excellent first throw. Yes! Oh, what's the experience? What is the experience for this? From almost 2,000 to 6,423. A 14.5 multiplier. Holy fuck. Holy shit. Dragonite is level 59. Venusaur is level 49. Koffing went from 31 to 32. To 33. To 34. And Ammonite went from 31 to 32. To 33. Wanting to learn Protect, but it won't. And a 34. That's all I really wanted to see, is if that happened. Like, how much it went up by. I did not realize that it boosted it that much. Holy fuck and a half. My Rhydon is now level 51. Koffing is level 35. Ammonite is level 35. Also, I think Koffing and Ammonite are literally tied now, because they just keep leveling up the exact same rate. Hey, look at that! Koffing's evolving!
Weezing!
It's been a while since I've done any impressions.
Koffing to Weezing!
This Pokemon lives and grows by absorbing poison gas, dust, and germs that exist inside garbage. Aww. I wonder if it's happy doing that, or if it just does it to survive. Now all I really need to do is just evolve Ammonite into Amistar, and I'm done with this game as far as I know.
Oh, another sized one! Oh, please tell me I can do this. Bag. Golden Raz. Ready. No! Fuck! That's my bad. I got too greedy. I even knew I shouldn't have done it. Like, if I bet I can go back in the footage and say, no, don't do that, just by the look in my eye. Damn it. Venusaur grew to level 50. Charizard grew to level 48. Pikachu grew to level 72.
Omanyte is now level 36. Pikachu is literally double of what Omanyte is, and Omanyte was at level 4, maybe 40 minutes ago. Come on, Sizeridon. No, not again! God damn it! Okay, now it's just being a bitch. Okay, now it's just being a fucking dick and a half. I am so fucking glad that... I am so glad that I didn't, like, get that type of throw when I had the chance to actually get it, and even though it was my fault. But I am so glad, because occasionally you just do a different throw, and there's no indication as to when you will do that. And I don't get it. I don't know why it does it. If I can just get, three more first throws, or three more sized, Rhydons, it doesn't really matter, because, like, wants to learn Rock Slide, because the 1,595 is actually enough to boost it to, is boost it up another level. Oh, wait. Needs 4,219. Oh well, I don't know how much it actually works. Rock Slide 75 and 90, also making it flinch. Water Gun, it's a water type, I'll keep it for now. 60 and flinch. Rock Throw, what is this? 50 and 90, but no secondary effects. 75 and 90 plus flinch. Oh yeah, I'll definitely upgrade Rock Throw, because I can always substitute Constrict for something else out. Whoa, wait, how? That's still caught? I definitely want to go back and see that footage. That's pretty sus. Oh, Sizeridon. I don't care if it overlevels Omanyte a little bit. It's just more a matter of pride now. Last one. Oh, I've got it. There we go. 6,000 experience. It's gonna overlevel Omanyte, but I don't care. 8,000! Motherfucker, what? Holy fuck. Dragonite is now level 60. Rhydon is level 52. Venusaur is 51. Charizard went from 48 to 50. And Omanyte went from 38 to 39, to 40, to 41. And now Omanyte is evolving. 8,771 experience. Where does that calculation come from? It should have, like, every other one where it had 5 multipliers, it was 1595. And then the time that I get the first throw, excellent throw, all lined up, it was 6,000 something. And now it was 8,000? Or did I get a great throw the first time that I got a sized one that I actually succeeded in doing it? I don't know. It's sharp. Oh, wait. No. It must add, like, the, bonus, like, the catch combo as well. Maybe. I don't know, I'm trying to run numbers in my head. That doesn't add up. Why? Its sharp beak rings its mouth? Its sharp beak rings its mouth. Its shell was too big for it to move freely, so it became extinct. Aw. Ooh, I'm a starter wants to learn Spike Cannon. This is what I was worried about, but I think it just learns the move regardless, just from evolving. Spike Cannon will probably take, yep, 2 to 5 times. It can lead up to 100 damage. We'll definitely forget Constrict for that. Hell yeah.
Wow.
This is the prized one.
Alright.
Oh, I can catch another one. I could catch another one. I could catch another one. Do I really want to? Wait, I don't have any more berries. You know what? I'll try. This is just going to be a test. I'm going to use the other berry, the silver raspberry, and it should work just as well, I think. And see if the catch combo has anything to do with it. So I know that it was 8,000 before. I've got a question. How the fuck does that work? 3,278? Also, I'm sorry I look at my face cam instead of you guys, but how the fuck? I'm done. Pikachu grew to level 73. Rhydon grew to level 53. Venusaur grew to level 52. And Blastoise grew to level 54. Ooh! Oh my god, Blastoise is finally learning a move. Wants to learn Headbutt. Yeah. About fucking time. It still knows Tackle, for God's sake. Water Gun should be gone by now, because Bubble Beam is better than that. And Tackle should have been gone a while ago. I don't get this. Oh, wait. Now I get it. So, over on the right-hand side, when it was 8 feet 6 inches highlighted, that was the tallest one. That was the largest one of my personal records that I had ever seen of Rhydon. That is why it was so big. That's why the bonus multiplier was so big. It's because it was literally the biggest one. How am I supposed to? I can't control that. That's so stupid. And for now, I'm gonna end my journey here. It's been 4 hours of recording, and I feel bad that I've probably strained my computer this much, but it was worthwhile for recording this episode. Unfortunately, this series will no longer exist on this channel. Well, not exist. Not exist, just no longer have any episodes being made. I might do some more just in my own time, but for now, I'm gonna be moving on to the next series. But for now, all I can say is if you liked any part of this video, don't forget to leave a like down below. Leave any comments or any videos you want to see in the future. Don't forget to subscribe as well as ring the bell to let you know when I post another video. But in the meantime, without you guys, my life would be in pieces.